Hallo Freunde der analogen Unterhaltung, willkommen zurück im Studio der BerlinCon 2021. Ich bin's, der Pete. Neben mir sitzt der Aaron Wenderbeck und der hat sein eigenes Spiel mitgebracht, nämlich Shablam. Das heißt, wir haben ja ein sehr farbenfrohes Spiel auf dem Tisch und wir werden jetzt ins Englische wechseln, weil das für Aaron besser ist und dann werden wir das ein bisschen erklären. Ich werde das nicht übersetzen, wir werden dann einfach das Spiel kurz beschreiben. Aaron, thanks for being here. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being part of the show. And you have your own game here.
Yeah, what is Shablam? Right. Yeah, so Shablam is a midweight strategy game for 2 to 4 players. It should be played in, you know, 60 to 120 minutes. Yeah, so it is a game where you play as a drag queen. And your goal is to put on the most extravagant and over-the-top performance to this song that we have at the top. So it's a lip-sync performance to the song.
Okay,
we have
so this
here.
Is the performances we need to take place.
Yeah,
and
right.
Each of the players takes one of these. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so the game basically takes place over the course of one song.
Okay.
Yeah, and over the course of the game, you're moving around on the stage like a queen would in chess.
Okay.
And you're using that to pick up rhinestones. We'll be drawing cards from the display here, and you take lip tokens, depending on the color of the card that you're taking.
Okay.
You're spending your rhinestones to play dance moves from your hand.
Okay.
And this is the main way in which you're scoring points throughout the game. And every game will have different dance move categories set up here. So
okay, so how will the turn of a player be?
Yeah, so every turn you just follow these five steps.
You can give it to me if you like.
Yeah.
Because then hide ich das hier mal in the pattern. You know the five steps?
Yeah, I do.
Then you can explain them.
Yeah, okay, so the first step is always bedazzle. So this is how new rhinestones will come out into the board. So you just draw random rhinestones from the bag and fill in your current stage area, which is defined by the color of the stage.
So I would fill in all the green areas.
Right, exactly.
Okay, so except where I'm standing.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, cool.
That's bedazzle. Then you move. As I mentioned, you move like a queen in chess. You can move as far as you want in any direction.
Yeah.
You can't land on another queen.
So we cannot hit each other.
No, okay. No. Drag is not a contact sport.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
But you can move through other queens. So, you know, you could pass through if you would pay them a rhinestone from your own supply.
Okay, so then phase two is done, move of the queen is done.
Yeah, so also when you're moving, you're picking up the rhinestone.
Yes,
and you can take
this is the currency we take with us.
And you always take the rhinestone where you land, but also the ones on the way if they match the one that you land. So you can move more.
So I take one color of stones.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, then it notes draw a dance move card.
Yeah,
from
so you'll draw one of these five cards.
I can choose anyone.
Yeah, and then you just take lip tokens based off of the color of the rhinestone. So every card has a rhinestone on it, which is sort of duplicated at the bottom. And if I take a green card, there's three green cards here, so it means I take three lip tokens up here.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the next one is dance.
Yeah, so
that's why I like it.
Yeah, so then dancing is just playing a dance move card from your hand. So to play a dance move card, you would always spend a pair of rhinestones. Pair is always
two
matching colors, two that match.
Mm-hmm.
Some dance moves you can spend additional pairs of rhinestones to make them worth more points.
Okay, more.
Or increase their star quality.
Empower the card.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
This card I played here, you can only play it for one pair. So the card will just tell you exactly how you should score points.
So each card scores points.
Yeah.
This is
yeah.
the main way to score points, okay?
Yeah, and so you're going to get some score for playing a card, which you'll keep track of with these category tokens that you have on your player board. So you just keep track of the points you earn. Let's just say I earned 8 points here.
So each one is one of the tokens.
So yeah, so you keep track of your points in each category of dance move.
Cool.
And then, yeah, lip sync comes at the end. Where you
Aber also, ob man auch die Noten trifft, die da gesungen werden, das ist ja richtig.
Yeah, so you are spending your lip tokens in order to claim lyrics. So you can claim as many lyrics as you want.
Yeah.
As long as you pay how many lips are at the bottom there.
Do I need to start from the left?
Yeah, you always start at the beginning of the song and go to the end. So, yeah, if I would spend 6 lips, I would take the first two.
Yeah.
And just keep them, you know, in my supply, and these would also be worth points. So you always, the cards that you're playing, you're always keeping in front of you, just in a stack here. And the points that you get from your lip sync are always going to be applied to whatever your top okay. category is. So in this case, it would just go directly.
Then
to,
I have three more questions.
Yeah.
How does the game end?
Yeah, so the game will end at the end of the song.
Okay.
So when you reveal the checkered flag, that will signal the last round.
Okay, and then playing. If you play with more players, then we yeah. just fill in mm-hmm. the second.
Yeah,
okay.
the song basically is the it's length longer, of the game.
Okay,
yeah.
cool.
Yeah.
Is there an end game scoring condition?
Yes, yeah, so one thing I didn't mention was earning 10. So if you score 10 or more points in a category, you will attend that category.
Okay.
So the first game, so the first game and scoring is 10s across the board, in which you will score points equal to your last category.
Okay.
You get points for having different colors of lyrics at the end.
Okay.
Then we just go through every category. So you just get
points.
So
like these over here.
Yeah, so these, you just get points for every,
different color.
All the points you've accumulated in a category okay. are worth endgame points.
Ah, okay.
We sort of skipped over these desire tokens. So these are just little tasks that the judges want you to do as you're playing the game. So if you're able to perform or just do what they ask, then you just take these tokens and put them on your player board. So
okay.
each desire token is also worth points at the end of the game. And if you manage to get sets of them, they will also be okay. worth additional points.
Cool.
Yeah.
Then you just close the third question I had.
Okay.
Shablam still looks like a prototype, so how...
Yeah, so it's going to be
how
on...
How will it be in the future?
It will be on Kickstarter in about 5 or 6 weeks.
So okay.
Yeah, at the end of October is the plan.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, this is obviously as good as I can make the game look with my home printer and stuff. So,
and then you go to Kickstarter and have everything else already planned. You have
yeah, so yeah, manufacturing and whatnot is already planned.
I just
yeah, now it's just seeing how many to make.
Okay, yeah. Aaron, I thank you for being here. Ich hoffe, ihr hattet Spaß. Ihr habt guten Eindruck bekommen, wie man hier in Shablam als Drag Queen die Bühne beansprucht und auf schön noch auftritt mit diesem Lip-Sync. Das sind auf jeden Fall sehr lustige Ideen. Falls ihr es nicht mitbekommen habt, Ende Oktober soll das Ganze auf Kickstarter kommen. Da werden wir vielleicht dann auch nochmal drüber reden. Und ich sage auf jeden Fall danke fürs Zuschauen. Aaron, thanks for being here.
Yeah, thanks
and,
for having me.
Ich hoffe, wir haben alle noch eine schöne Messe. Ich sage auf bald. Ciao.
Ciao.